Since the first demonstration of a fully functioning laser by Theodore Maiman in 1960, the power of this system has steadily increased, while the duration of the emitted light pulses has shrunk. One important step in this path has been the development of the CirPulse amplification scheme by Donna Strickland and Gerard Mourou, for which they were awarded the Nobel Prize in Physics in 2018. Thanks to these and many other contributions, modern-day laser systems are able to provide pulses that, when focused, show extremely huge electric fields, comparable with the ones that are binding electrons inside atoms. In this high-intensity interaction, a great variety of new physical phenomena can take place, such as the emission of very high-order harmonics of the driving laser, also named HAG. In order to explain this process, we can consider the simple three-step model as developed by Schaffer and Korkum. In the first step, the Coulomb potential of the atomic target is bent by the external field, so that the outermost electron can escape under the barrier, tunnel ionizing the system. In the second step, the freed electron is accelerated by the laser, firstly away from the parent ion, and then back towards it, as the external field is reversed. Finally, in the last step, the electron can recombine with the parent ion, releasing all the accumulated kinetic energy, with the emission of an XUV photon. The HAG process can also be explained in the framework of quantum mechanics, as first demonstrated by Levenstein and co-workers. In this case, the light emission is described by the oscillating dipole originating from the interference between the part of the electron wave function that is tunnel ionized and the one that remains bound to the atom. The final expression is rather complex, but it can be broken down in three parts, each one connecting with one step of the semi-classical model. The properties of the emitted radiation can thus be well understood with the simpler three-step model. Firstly, depending on the instant in the external field at which the electron exits the barrier, it will undergo a different path which is almost completely determined by the external strong field. In this way, we can link the ionization phase with the recombination phase and with the accumulated kinetic energy using simple Newtonian mechanics. In this way, it is possible to show that for each energy of the emitted radiation, two trajectories are present, up until a cutoff, which is determined by the intensity of the driving field, its wavelength, and the ionization potential of the atom. In particular, these trajectories can be classified in two main classes, depending on the time spent by the electron in the free space, and are thus called short and long trajectories. Moreover, the recollision takes place every half cycle from opposite directions, as the external field reverses its sign. Therefore, if we consider a centrosymmetric target, such as an atom, the spectrum of the emitted radiation is composed by the odd harmonics only of the driving frequency. This is due to the interference between the light produced into opposite half cycles, which exhibits a pi phase shift. Finally, to explain the last point, we can move to the generation room. Here, we can see a typical experimental system for the generation of high-order harmonics. HAG is a coherent upconversion process, which means that the emitted radiation shows extremely good temporal and spatial coherence inherited by the driving field. However, this means also that we have to consider the phase matching condition inside an extended medium in order to describe the build-up of the harmonic radiation. Indeed, in an actual experiment, the laser does interact with a single atom, but usually with a gas jet provided by a valve. Therefore, the radiation emitted by each single atom can efficiently sum up only if the polarization induced by the driving laser propagates in phase with the harmonic radiation. Such condition is fulfilled when the momentum conservation for the upconversion process is satisfied. This is determined by four main terms. The first one accounts for the difference in the refractive index seen by the two waves due to the medium dispersion. The second is linked to the presence of a free electron plasma owing to the unavoidable ionization connected with the first step of the HAG process. The third arises from the geometry of the interaction, which, in the most common case of a focused Gaussian beam, reduces to the spatial derivative of the well-known Gouy phase. Finally, the last one accounts for the phase accumulated by the electron during its path in free space, which depends on the undertaken trajectory. In a real experiment, all these terms should be managed in order to maximize the harmonic signal using few experimental tricks. Only then, the unique properties of HAG can be exploited for designing peculiar light sources, gaining information about the generating target, or even for producing isolated attosecond pulses, which are the shortest event
ever created by mankind.
The number of applications of high harmonic generation is nowadays considerable. In the following video, few of the most attractive ones will be explored in more details.